Recently on this channel, we have been putting a lot of attention on Ethereum competitors such as the Binance Smart Chain, Cardano, Polkadot, and also yesterday we posted a video on Solana. And some people are asking us the question, have you forgotten about Ethereum? Have you given up on it? And of course, the answer is no. We love Ethereum on this channel. Ethereum is the go-to smart contract platform. And in fact, as we have been making these videos, Ethereum has continued its rapid expansion in the usage of its network while taking a break from the spotlight. Aside from that, a long-awaited update to the Ethereum network finally has been given a confirmed date of implementation. In this video, I am going to be sharing with you some on-chain data that shows that Ethereum is stronger than ever in spite of recent claims that other blockchains have been drawing users away from it. I will also be sharing the details of the upcoming Berlin hard fork and a separate potential Ethereum upgrade that would drastically decrease gas fees, which I would like to see absolutely, as well as updating you on the rising levels of institutional interest in Ethereum. I know that sometimes it can be easy to overlook Ethereum because of how familiar it is and the hype around all of the newer chains gaining popularity, but doing so is a mistake because even at its current price, Ethereum could still be one of the best overall investment opportunities across all of crypto right now. Before I get started, make sure to subscribe and turn on post notifications if you enjoy being kept up to date on all of the most exciting and important events going on in the world of crypto, as well as how I am trading and the best altcoin investment opportunities. I cover pretty much everything you need in order to make money in the crypto space. So to start off with, let me just show you all some data about the Ethereum network that disproves any of the claims being spread around that the Binance Smart Chain or any other chains are causing significant amounts of people to leave Ethereum. First up, this chart shows the number of daily transactions on the Ethereum network. As you can see, it fluctuates a lot, but it's still generally trending upwards towards new all-time highs. Next, if we take a look at the total number of unique addresses on Ethereum, it is still seeing extremely steady growth and is approaching 150 million addresses. Last but definitely not least, the price of Ethereum is also seeing extremely strong growth as it consolidates a bit below its recent created highs. All of this information just goes to show that while people and crypto news sources may be talking a lot more about Binance Smart Chains and other new chains, that does not in any way mean that Ethereum is losing momentum or that people are giving up on it. Of course, some people are going to move from Ethereum to the other chains, but this data suggests that Ethereum is stronger than ever. Now that that is out of the way, let's look at the Ethereum network upgrade known as the Berlin hard fork. This fork was actually originally scheduled for last summer but was delayed due to concerns about the GETH client, and that is the client that most Ethereum nodes run on. So, after some changes, the Ethereum developers have decided that it is safe to perform the fork now and have scheduled it at block height 12,244,000. So the Berlin fork will be implementing 5 different Ethereum improvement proposals that will bring some important changes to how Ethereum works on a technical level. If you are interested in the details of these proposals, then you can read all about them on the Ethereum GitHub page, but most of that is beyond our level of understanding. So a more simple explanation of what the upgrades will do is that they include various optimizations for smart contracts, including gas efficiencies, updates to how code is read by the Ethereum virtual machine, and other changes to protect against DDoS attacks against Ethereum. While these are all things that could bring some smaller improvements to the current gas fees, they are not as exciting as a different Ethereum improvement proposal that is currently being discussed. That would be EIP 1559, and if implemented, it could significantly decrease Ethereum gas fees by changing the entire fee model of the network. To understand how IEP 1559 would work, you first need to understand the current fee model. Right now, Ethereum utilizes a basic auction system to decide which transactions are confirmed first. Simply put, whoever pays the highest gas fees gets their transaction confirmed first. Unfortunately, this system is not a very efficient one due to the fact that miners must estimate the appropriate fee required to complete the transaction. This leads to users paying different amounts to have their transactions included in the same block. It has been estimated that switching from the inefficient auction system to the system they want to implement right now, that could potentially save 90% of user transaction costs. Obviously, that is a very large improvement and could be the catalyst needed to send Ethereum's price soaring, because in reality, the primary obstacle holding it back from its full potential is the high gas costs right now. So let's talk about this, and I will give you an overview of how the new fee structure would look like. Instead of having a highest fee wins system, transaction fees would be split into two parts, a base fee and a tip. The base fee would be determined by a dynamic algorithm that aims to keep the Ethereum network at 50% utilization. By setting a base fee, users would no longer have the responsibility of estimating how much gas they need to include to get their transaction approved. Additionally, the base fee would actually be burned, which would introduce a deflationary mechanism into the network. As you all know, when supply is decreased, price tends to go up. So this would be an exciting benefit alongside of the cheaper fees. Now, some of you are probably thinking that if there is an option to include tips with the transactions, then won't things just end up how they are now, with whoever sends the highest amount getting their transaction confirmed first? The answer is actually no. As I mentioned earlier, the algorithm will aim for 50% network utilization. This means that each block would be about 50% full. The other 50% of that block would be allocated to transactions with tips included. This would work out so that you could either send a transaction with no tip and wait the average amount of time, or send it with a tip to be included in an earlier block. There are also some more technical aspects of this proposed upgrade, as it is usually the case, of course. If all of this is a little confusing, that is completely okay, because all you need to know about it is that if this is actually implemented, you will be paying significantly less in gas. So that sounds good. It sounds amazing. And you are probably wondering, why isn't it being implemented as soon as possible? The short answer to that question is that there are only so many Ethereum developers around right now, and they have also been needing to work on Ethereum 2.0 as well as multiple other projects relating to the network. Additionally, of course, every upgrade must undergo extremely thorough testing before being implemented. This usually involved being deployed on 4 or more testnets and surviving security and stress testing. Aside from all of that, the Ethereum community must be consulted as well. That part of the process is actually occurring in just a few days, on February the 26th, when there will be a community call to discuss the implementation of this proposal. And you can expect an update video after that call to let you all know what was discussed. So this is an extremely exciting topic. We will keep you updated, so make sure to subscribe. If you are not yet subscribed right now, activate the bell in order to get that information firsthand. Now, a quick update on institutional interest in Ethereum. As you probably know, Ethereum futures launched on the CME a few weeks ago. They are already seeing significant daily volume. As you can see on the CME site right here, during the last trading period, there was 928 contracts traded with open interest of 911 contracts. Each contract represents 50 Ethereum, meaning that those 928 contracts represent about $92 million. On the grayscale side of things, there are still buying up significant amounts of Ethereum, with more than 27,000 Ethereum purchased in the last week and 223,000 purchased in the last month. This brings their total holdings up to a value of more than $6 billion. Nice. Okay, institutional interest is definitely there. So I hope all of this information has shown you that things are as bullish as ever in regards to Ethereum, especially if this new proposal gets approved and implemented. That is going to solve a lot of the problems we have in Ethereum right now. At that point, Ethereum 2.0 would not even be necessary to move forward with mass adoption of Ethereum. Combining that with a deflationary mechanism and then a $2,000 Ethereum seems like a steal compared to what it could be then. If you enjoyed this video, then make sure to subscribe and you can stay up to date with everything going on in the crypto markets. Thank you so much for watching. Let's jump over to the Solana video right now. It is popping up in the middle of this video. It is actually a very interesting platform. So if you like Cardano, Ethereum, Polkadot, you're probably going to be interested in Solana as well. So let's jump over to it. I will see you right there.